News at your fingertips, wherever you are and whenever you want. The late news at the end of the day, it's all the news you need.
This is the town of Medica, once a border town of just 2,800 people. It's now on the front lines of a humanitarian crisis. Thousands streaming across the border every day with just what they can carry, and they need help.
This has become an unfortunate part of the early morning ritual here in Lviv. The air raid siren goes off just before dawn. Everybody has to head down to the basement or their bunkers. In this case, it's the casino of this hotel, and wait for either government radio or an internal messaging app that the hotel has to tell them it's safe to leave. I understand that this air raid siren relates to attacks that are going on right now in Mykolaiv and Dnipro.
No part of Ukraine now feels safe for many people, even here in the west of the country. Yesterday's airstrike on a military base northwest of Lviv has seen more people running for the border. Well, yes, Jen, the Prime Minister has a touchdown, and just within hours he came down here to the grounds that surround Buckingham Palace to lay flowers on behalf of the country. The PM said that the Queen lived a life of great service and that that garnered her great respect from around the world, in particular from Australians. Right now, though, he is on his way to Kent, where he will have a meeting with the UK's new Prime Minister, Liz Truss, before later in the day he will return to Westminster Hall to visit the Queen lying in state. Every street, every motorway on the Queen's last great journey has looked like this. Britons lining the street just to get a glimpse of her hearse. The sense of national mourning here is immense.
Ursula Heger joins me now live from Negombo, just north of the capital, Colombo. Ursula, a lot of difficult days still ahead for the people of Sri Lanka.
Well, yes, that's right, Hugh. Today is a national day of mourning, but one day that will continue for many days ahead. We have seen a number of mass funerals today for some of the 310 people who have lost their lives in these terrorist attacks. Just to give you an indication about just how tense the situation here is, about 15 minutes ago we were told there was an explosion just down here near St. Anthony's Church. Now, we don't yet know whether that is a controlled explosion or whether another bomb has gone off, but I can tell you that when we arrived here, we saw a number of the media here running about, panicked, because they'd heard that there was another explosion just a couple of streets away from here. We've only been here just a couple of days now, but many of the island's locals have told us they don't believe the Tamil family should have been brought here. In fact, they don't want these centres operating here anymore. The government could use the cost of this family's own detention against them, using it to stop them from applying to come back to Australia in the future. All up, around 2,300 people are winging their way across the Tasman today. But while most on these early flights are there to see friends and family, tourism chiefs are banking on these seats being filled with holiday makers in time for the ski season. While domestic tourism has helped get them through, usually 40% of the customers at businesses, including this one, are Aussies. Well, mainly the brave ones.
The Duke and Duchess are making their way across to the Bennelong Pavilion at the Sydney Opera House for the New South Wales Premier's official reception for the Invictus Games. We'll hope this storm will pass, because they'll only stay there for about 20 minutes and then they'll make their way down to the forecourt of the Opera House for the official opening ceremony of the Invictus Games.
But questions are already being asked if part of this pain could have been avoided. Some residents blame releases from the nearby Wyangla Dam for adding to the flood peak.
This is the problem that they're facing here in these areas. Spot fires are appearing ahead of the front and threatening homes. Firefighters then have to deal with multiple fronts, and they are stretched to their limits.
This is the actual fire front that's tearing along this ridge to Nethercote. Firefighters have made the decision to try and defend this property despite it being in dense bushland. They're now putting themselves between the fire front and the house. Well, Hugh, conditions here are truly unbelievable. I'll take you around for a little bit so you get a sense of what it's like here. But this is the little town of Eden, and all day long it has been shrouded in this incredibly thick smoke. For most of the day, the sky was a burnt orange colour. That has only cleared out now because incredibly rain has been falling here. It is just bizarre.
UK police have said the charge relates to an incident involving a police officer who was responding to a complaint involving a taxi fare on January the 30th last year in Twickenham, an area southwest of London. Now, this alleged incident...
That's the funniest thing. Oh, that's great. That's a bloopers tape, baby. You kept trying to do it.
One of the most ridiculous moments of my life.